be some old ones, but you don't know them. You have never even tried them. So let's try this old one. Hallelujah.
This.
This was not there last time?
Of course.
But is there anything else around here that you have noted that was not there last Sunday? Yes, some of you can spot that one, the ceiling. Now there are some of you that entered through that door. Look up. If you entered through that door and you are somewhere there, look up. Anything you can see up there?
Yes.
Now that is how it's going to look, all this. So if you want to know what will look, this place will look like, walk through that door and look up. You will see some of the ceiling boards that are going to be this place. Last Sunday, by the grace of God, I was here half. Then I left. Alice left for my fashion. And she is not here this morning. But she is coming in the second service. Tulibarikiwa jana sana. Bwana asifiwe sana. Na gari yangu ilikuja ikijishika mahindi. Kujita mahindi huko. Sieni. Safari tatu. Na unajua shida hizi magari zinakuwa na kompyuta. Huwezi enda kupuliza kapuleta kwa sababu haina. Sasa wewe unakaa tu na kuomba. Lakini I have very good prayer for team. We prayed 3 times. And we got home. Then we had a visitor who was taking an airport. That's why we were trying to run very fast. And it's good to have people that you can call like this. Ingia gari, kibia kwangu, chukua huyo, pereka mwanja wa ndege. Let's appreciate Sheila Wanjiku Mati for doing that. Just called that, we were in the room, but before we got there, she was there and took our visitor to the airport. Can I tell you something also that happened? I forgot Peter Sonny is closer to me. Seriously. We were asking ourselves, no, we cannot have where yet. We forgot. When Sheila said yes, then we remembered all of you. We remembered Waura, we remembered, you know, and it was so amazing. The heart of and so on. In Arkansas. But when we were struggling, we were asking, no, who? And then immediately Sheila came to mind. Then we remembered all the others. And we said, Sasa ya baraka ikuwa ya Sheila. I don't know whether you are like me, sometimes you go black. Oh. Now, ukipiga simu, ukiangalia simu nakuta, simu haiko hiyo, ile unatafuta. That's what happened yesterday, but we thank God for friends. Because our sister got to the airport, she would have been late. And then the husband was also getting worried. Because simu zetu ziliisha moto. Sasa anapigiwa na mke wake akiwa kwangu. Naye anajaribu kutupigia. Can you imagine the panic? He called me later and said, nitumu makita kuna kutumia wako, anamone woka. Said, don't you worry, we had a problem. But we are so grateful for friends. So I'm appreciating a friend and the many friends that you have and that you can call when you have a need. And when you're called, please, when you're called. Hallelujah. When you're called. Don't behave like a friend of mine. I was so sick. And I had a car and I could not drive myself. And I called him. Well, he was my neighbor here. And an elder in his church. When I said this, I'm going to call him. And he said, "Enda kuambia kwanza ninakula, nikimaliza kula nitakuja." Do you know I got energy? I told my wife, "Nitaendesha hii gari." Pale ikasimama isimame. By that time, my wife was not a driver. Lakini hata akakasirikia pale. Sababu huyu ni bwana yake anafariki hapa na ameugua na umwa. Na kuna mzee wa dini anasema akule ugali kwanza. Ukiitwa, wacha ugali. If you are visiting us for the very first time, we want to appreciate you, please. We want you to lift up your hand and support you quickly. We welcome you to this wonderful express service. And please, let's talk about express service. Bless you, my sister. Bless you. Thank you for coming. And let's appreciate our sister. Our meeting, especially this express service. I met a member of our church who goes to work at about 9, but they don't know whether we have an express service. So let's talk about it and encourage people to come so that we can have this.
his express service and we leave in good time. I want to talk about distraction. Tell your neighbor distraction. Distraction. Things that distract us from the course that God has called us. Distraction. A story is told of a person that used to tame and work on tigers to make them perform. And one day he goes into the tent and he's ready to introduce what he was going to do. And he comes with a tiger and he had named the tiger Roy. And he told the audience, "This animal has never done this before. This is the first time. So let's appreciate the tiger." So the people appreciated the tiger. But the tiger got distracted and got a hold of this man introducing the tiger, pulled his hands, and pulled him down. And people started cheering the more because they thought, what an act. Then the tiger pulled him backstage. And at the backstage, it started huddling and enjoying the men. He screamed and people went to hell. And they discovered it was not an act when somebody went to the stage and said, the show is over. But the question is, what distracted the tiger? Tamed, worked on, but on the stage that day there was some destruction and the tiger could not perform the way it used to perform. What is that thing that distracts you from the course of what God has told you? Because I know there are many things that distract us. A distraction at any level can be fatal. You know, fatal can be serious, can be destructive. However, worse than any distraction that leads to a fatality is the harsh reality that many people have allowed distractions to become spiritual fatal. They have allowed this spiritual fatal distraction to cloud their vision and to cloud their journey with the Lord. They have obstructed or allowed distraction to obstruct them. An obstruction is something that is put before you, which hinders you from seeing beyond. For example, where we are, we have this building, it is an obstruction. We cannot see the shops up there, and we cannot see where Mungu lives behind us. The building becomes a little obstruction. For you to see far, you have to go up. And I normally think I'm very courageous. Don't you think I'm courageous? But let me tell you the truth, I'm not. Boru is so courageous. You know, Boru? I want to see him up there, walking up there, and telling you the truth without hiding anything. Pale. See, where's his mama? Pale. Unless kuna ngazi. Na ni ngazi ambayo nimeangalia vizuri kama inaweza nishikilia. There are some of us that ukienda gorofa ya tatu uangalie chini, miguu inakosa nguvu. But there are some of us that can go to the 28th floor or the 70th floor and you look down and you have no problem. So there are some that have courage to do things, but obstruction hinders even when you think you're courageous. I swim. Amen? I swim. But I only swim on one direction. I have never tried to swim looking at the sky. And they tell me it is simple. And I tell you what simple. I try in a group of magic to a guy. See, I'm going to be a man to even there. So what happens because we are not courageous enough, there are some things that we don't try at all. We get scared about. And that being scared becomes
and distraction, we don't get to our goal. Things that distract us. It's like chasing an antelope, and you're so happy about it. Then around the truth. And then you think, there's a kashika of pace. Lo and behold, you lose the antelope and you lose the rabbit. And there are some people who are like that. Your goals and aims are big enough, but as you pursue them, all of a sudden something significant, something tiny, something small hinders you from getting to where you want to get to. In the book of Judges, chapter 13 to chapter number 16, there is a story of a man that was called Manoah. Manoah had lived with his wife and they had no child, but God told the wife that you're going to have a son. And he was told what to do with the son, because the son was going to be a Nazarite and the son was going to deliver the children of Israel. So he was told, no razor, no wine, no nothing. But if you follow the story, you discover this, that Samson, indeed, he became what God had said. Because God's promises are true. What God says you can become, you will become. But then watch out for distraction, things that can take you away from what God has called you to do. And there are many. For Samson, one day he's walking around, and he sees a beautiful girl. And you are not supposed to marry from there. Now, of course, theologians, they look at it and say, how could he kill them if he had not married them? He would have still fought them, but his fight was deterred. His winnings were put down by that destruction that came. And even when the first lady he wanted to marry was taken by someone, he still went back there and got into a hallowed place. And you know the story. His future was robbed because he was distracted. Your future can be robbed. And there are many of us, even some of you listening to me, if you're not careful, your future is at a crossroads. And there is something that is distracting you. There is something that wants to pull you away from the course and the journey that the Lord has called you. I will never forget this. We used to live with one of my sister-in-law. And I used to live with my sister-in-law and a cousin. And they had both finished Form 4. They were living with us. We wanted them to go to the university. I wanted my cousin. And he was called to KU to go and study. And they were there with my sister-in-law. They both agreed going to the university. Haina kazi. After the song, and I want to come back. You know, there are some people who believe that. But I normally say, don't believe that. Go to college. Finish college. Let God handle the rest. After all, you'll be a wise person without a job. Instead of becoming ignorant and without a job. Yani, ninaweza kuwa mimi napiga matatu kwa mbavu, lakini nasema niko na MBA yangu. Hata Kiingereza yangu, hata maana zangu zinaweza kuwa tofauti. Hata usafi wangu utakuwa tofauti. Ndio kuna makanga alifanya mkono hii kidogo, basi sawa, ni pole sana kwa kazi. Lakini kuna mwingine, hata unasikia ni kama amejipiga korono. Korono ilikuwa kitu kingine ya miaka yetu. So what I'm saying is, but I was not courageous enough. But I tell you, my wife was courageous enough. 1 week before Nairobi University, first year student was supposed to appear, she addressed the sister. I have never seen Alice, not annoyed, but fun. She told her, "Oh, what are you going to do? Why are you going to do that? What are you going to do?" We carried on. By that time, she was working in the Kidogo, Ukutao, and Akoa Giritano. But this is the story. I want to finish this story by telling you this. The distraction for my sister-in-law was 5,000. But to remove the obstruction, Alice had to say, go tell your father. And
And thy knows the father I'm talking about. Yeye na kivomo uwezi cheza naye. Ameamua, ameamua. So anyway, to cut the story short, she finally went to the university. She did her first degree here. She applied for the university in Atlanta without anybody of us knowing to go and do masters. Kwa sababu alipo ondoa hiyo distraction. Akajua masomo sio hela zile unapata sasa, ni zile utapata then. Sasa hapa Australia. Distraction. And there are some of us that believe the lie and it becomes a distraction to us. So last can rob us. In the Gospel of Luke chapter number 18, verse 18 to 23, we read of another story. A young man goes to Jesus and he says, good teacher. And Jesus tells him, there is none of us who's good. But Jesus explains something because this guy had gone to Jesus to know one thing. How can I inherit the kingdom of God? And Jesus said, go do all the commandments. And the man says, I have done all of them. Can you imagine? And Jesus had no problem with that because this guy had really done all of them. He said, your turn, the father. But I want to tell you the attitude he had was not right. That's what theologians tell us. That his attitude, the way as he spoke to the Lord Jesus Christ, he said, mimi niko na yote na nimetosha yote na hata mali niko na yametosha. And then Jesus threw an attitude in him and said, do you want really? There's one thing that you have not handled. Handle your wealth well. Who sell, give to the poor, follow me. And the Bible says, he got offended. Yani alikasirika sana. Mimi nataka kwenda mbinguni with my own terms. I want to go to heaven the way I am. I don't want anybody to come and touch me. This guy, what was distracting him was wealth. Wealth. Utajiri. Unajua, hebu nikwambie ukweli wa mama. Tukiwa vijana na mko hapa vijana, unatumia afya yako kununua mashamba, kununua gari, afya yako kutafuta mali. Lakini nikwambie ukweli wa mama, ukichunga uzee wako utatumia hiyo mali kulinda afya yako. Let me say it in English. When you are young, you use your health to make wealth. Without knowing, you are hurting yourself. So finally, you use all that wealth because you are not healthy. So what do I need? Healthy. How to be healthy? Ati kunataka kufanya kazi 24/7. Wacha. You know, this week as I thought about that, there was a friend of mine who used to wake up at about 3 so that he can be in Gongori around 4, buy a meal so that he can be back at Kawa West at 6, so that he can go to work in Nakuru. He used to work in Nakuru. And he did it. And we would meet and you say, what is it in Nakuru? I do it. I do all this, everything. Then I go to Nakuru to work. Let's go to talk about who is not your friend. This who is not my friend was working in Atlanta, Georgia. And he had 3 jobs. Kutoka hii unaenda hii, kutoka hii unaenda hii. Hili, wewe bwana, tafuta utajiri. So after a couple of months, almost a year, there was an accumulation of sleep. And he didn't know. Actually, he used to tell the others, me when I went to Jomo Kenyatta International Airport, I left my sleep there. I've come to the U.S. to look for this. One day, he is moving from one job, rush home to change, go to another, because you see, you have to put uniforms. Then he was stopped by street lights. Well, I just sit there in a book and I can tell you, Joseph,
How many seconds, how many minutes?
Yauko kwenu. Najua huyu amekuwa kule dakika tatu. Hizo dakika tatu alilala usingizi kali.
Dakika tatu.
Akapigiwa honi, hakusikia. Watu wa Amerika ni wazuri sana, wakapigia ile gari ya polisi. Ukipiga gari ya polisi ya Amerika, zinakujaga gari ngapi?
Tatu.
Gari ngapi?
Tatu.
Moja ni ya polisi,
nine.
Pili ni ya mbura. Tatu ni gari ya kukuruta.
Wezi kaa kwa hayo.
Aliangushwa na mataa ya hizo magari, kwa sababu zote zina mataa kama ya nine. Alipoanguka akakataa, by the grace of God, ni clean. Kwa hivyo akaenda.
Oh, alisimamishwa hapo mbele. Kaambia, sir, you've been in that situation for 1 hour. We cannot allow you to drive, sir.
What was it, sir? We cannot allow you to drive, sir.
Where do you live, sir?
They're very kind.
Uyo si rafiki yangu. Na ni vizuri kuongea mambo ambayo si rafiki yangu. Na mwingine ambaye si rafiki yangu naye anaenda Ulaya, London. Anafanya kazi hiyo.
Usingizi ikakuta yeye winter. Unfortunately UK watu wanangojaga train.
Sio kama America kila mtu ana gari lake.
Sasa ametoka nasi, ni nasi usiku, nataka kwenda nyumbani na nyingine. Na kuna baridi amejifunga vizuri,
vile tumejifunga.
Si hivi umejifunga vizuri? Na akausikia kale kake. Kakakuja. Kakamshika. Wana.
Alikuja akapigwa ile akangua kama kitu. Kwa sababu kila mahali palikuwa pameshikana. Na alipelekwa mahali awe warmed up. Ili miguu iwache kuachilia.
Yes, well, can.
Now, I know you want me to go back to what happened to my friend. He died. He had an accident. Because he slept.
Na hizi na barabara mtu wanararaka kidogo sana.
What is that?
Is it well? I'm talking to you. Watch out that it doesn't take you away from the course and the focus that the Lord has given us. So the possession of this young man was a fatal distraction. He will not focus. He will not enjoy the Ten Commandments that he kept. He will not enjoy the Lord that he trusted in. He will not enjoy God because of that wealth had distracted him. In Genesis 25, verse 29 to 34, hunger. Esau sold his birthright because he allowed his momentary hunger to distract him. Oh, if I can. And you know, sometimes hunger can be very, very, very tempting.
But where I come from, we say Nadikimu. You don't give, you give it so small and it forgets. It will not do like a hour. Kwa hivyo hata kupewa tu hiyo supu ya malenge ama supu ya pocho, it made Esau sell his birthright. Sold his birthright. Distraction for food.
Food. And you can add on, there are many things that distract you because you do yourself.
And it can be fatal. The point is, that can be fatal for you. In Genesis 19, verse 26,
this is the story of Lot's wife. While God was trying to bring Lot and his family out of destruction, Lot's wife turned back and was turned into a pillar of salt because she allowed herself to be distracted by her past. You can be distracted by your past. Somebody preached here and said you can be stuck in your past. Nikama matope, umekwama, kwa mambo ya zamani. Yani, you can be distracted by your past. Past is okay, but don't stay there. Oh, past, don't stay there. It has happened. Move on. Obama, the president, They helped the president of the U.S., single mother, the father left the mother, but God knew Obama would be the president. Regardless of carrying his name, he did not carry his past. You know, if there is someone who has suffered scorn because of having a Kenyan blood, is that guy. But that guy even enjoyed himself. He said, oh, yes, I'm born in Mombasa. And when he came, he also wanted to know which place in Mombasa, you know, when he was a senator. Because you see, it is all over the place. Where is Mombasa? Mombasa. But you refuse to be stuck and to be distracted by the past. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Because the past is past and it is gone. What happened, happened. And there is nothing I can do now. All what I need is to live with the scar and move on. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I will not lament about it. I will not even talk about it for sympathy. I'm going to believe God that I have a better future. My past is past and gone. And there is very little I can do about it. Can you imagine now if we all came here one day and we want to mourn the church that was here? Like, to go journey to the organism. Hiyo kanisa tulibomoa. Jamani, hiyo tulibomoa. Na kubomoa kulikuwa kukari na mbao tukatuma Malzabet. Haiko huku, hakuna mabati ya hiyo church. Yote tulituma Malzabet. Sasa ukitaka kuiona, wenda kurugu, sili kurugu kuma ni watu huko. Ukayone huko, sili imetenga boarding ya wasichana huko. So you go there, tulibomoa hii na tukawa transport. Because we cannot keep on lamenting the past. Let not the past distract you. Oh, I wish I could have done this. Wish you could not have done, and if there is no way you can do it, forget it. If I can improve, I will. But if I cannot, it is a negative thing. I refuse to be stuck. I refuse to be distracted by the past. What was happening in Lot's wife? I think she doubted. God cannot do that. Now, the question is, how did the Lord know? I want to believe Lord was behind us, like a good father. Papa, what are you there? Can you angalia watu wako kama wanavuka vizuri? Wacha kuwa wale wazee wa zamani. Tunaenda na Ivashi ambakuta Bwana Francis. Francis is my father. You see, Kimani, no more calls in there. You're the one who's in there. Remember, I have to be a book. Am I okay? So we normally say ladies fast, but men in front in Africa because of lions. Are you getting the point? Because there are lions out there. Don't allow anything in the past in there. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I hope that last look became fatal for Lot's wife. You can see that destructions can be the cause of somebody's dream being destroyed and future never coming to pass. Therefore, destruction can be the difference, and I want you to, if you're writing like this, destruction can be the difference between possibility and reality. Destructions can be the difference between possibilities and reality. And I have come this morning with a very simple thought. Listen, don't let anything distract you from God and what He has for you. Don't allow anything to distract you from God and what He has for you. Don't let anything get in the way of you and your relationship with God. Many people are distracted by their past, wondering if God can really use them. Can God use my past? And if He really cares about them, does God really think about me? Why did this happen May God help us and save us from destruction. Questions that we can ask ourselves: is my relationship with him, or with the her, or with the them, or in the church, is my relationship ever going to be what it once was? Those can be distractions. Because it doesn't happen many times, twice. Some of you are distracted by the thoughts and events that have already unfolded. Trump is the president of the U.S. Trump is the president of the U.S. I say again, Trump is the president of the U.S. With everything that we know, Trump is there. It has happened. There is nothing you can do. Please don't pray for anything to happen. If you pray a prophet, after each year, the big deal, but shall die. So what has happened and fallen, it has happened, we live in. And what has happened would be questions like this. Why did they have to die? Why did he? And you know, we know it. It is appointed once for all of us to die. And after the judgment, but you discover you can live in the past. Why did he? Why did she? Especially for some of us that were left very young, we can live in the past and not pursue our cause. I refuse. My father died when I finished Form 4, and life, I knew it was going to be difficult, but I refused to stay there, but I kept on moving. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes, why did I have to go through that? Sometimes we are struggling. Why did I have to go through this? Why, God? Where were you when it was happening? That can also be a distraction to you. Why am I going through this? Maybe right now you're going through a situation, and that situation can be a distraction for you. Why am I going through this? Will revival ever really come to me? Will I, my spirit be revived again? Those are the questions that I'm going through. Will I ever get my financial breakthrough? Will I ever get a breakthrough in this life? Will I ever recover from my situation? Those are things that can distract you because you're only concerned about them. You don't do what you're supposed to do. These are all distractions that can be fatal to your relationship with God. The enemy would love you to be so caught up with distraction that you miss what God is really trying to do. God is doing a new thing. Understand, no matter what has happened to you, or what has happened to you now, God is still God. It doesn't matter what has happened and what is happening, God is still God. The enemy would love destruction to rob you of your faith and your hope in God. That is what the enemy would like to do. But God is still in control of your life. God has not left you, nor has he forsaken you. God is still with you. Don't let Satan distract you from the call of God in your life. Some questions you'll have will never get an answer. Some questions you have will never have an answer. But when the trumpet sounds, then we will all know why things happened the way they did. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Why was I born a Kikuyu? Why was I born in Karate? Why those questions? You know, those ones, we can get answers there. And some of the answers we'll get actually will shock us because we'll have missed the purpose of which God planted you where he planted. Because you kept lamenting and complaining and blaming every situation and circumstance. And I have said in this place, every high school has assigned them to the university of your choice. I have said that. And I have always believed that. I have always believed that.
asubuhi. Lakini Alice akamwangalia akakuta hiyo kiatu kinacheka kwa upande, ile smile ya upande. Your mother didn't wear a grey vest. So she gave me some money and I called him. I said, my wife wants you to buy a shoe. I never told him your shoes is not, it's money. No, he said. And he said, thank you, thank you. I'll come to your church one of these days when I'm passing by. Don't allow that to be a distraction. Don't allow it. I want to try to finish that which I have started. Let us again answer that to get a connection to wish. Let me try to plant. When we come to church every morning, the house of God, we cannot allow distractions of this world to be fatal in our Christian walk. Every time we come here, we need to be focused on God. It is up for our attention and it is up for our praise. Elijah and Ahab. Remember the story of Elijah and Ahab and the cloud? Just because you may not see it physically, yet that does not mean God isn't getting ready to do something. You might not see it physically, but God is in the business of doing something for us. Don't let what you cannot see distract you from the fact that God is still there. God is still there. Don't allow it to distract you. That which you cannot see, just keep on believing in the Lord, our God. Don't let what you have not received yet distract you from reaching for it. Why? There is a story in the Gospel of Luke. Luke 18, saying, there was a city church, which feared not God, neither regarded men. And there was a widow in that city. And she came unto him, saying, avenge for me, my adversary. And he would not for a while. Yet he said for a while, not listening. But afterward he said within himself, though I fear not God, nor regard men, yet because this widow troubleth me, I will avenge her, lest by her continue coming, she wearies me. She did not allow the first time failure to distract her. It does not matter how many times you have gone for that visa, you have gone for that appointment, you have gone for that interview, keep going. I know some of you know my wife ended up working with Kenya Power. She had done interviews in Kenya Power. Many. But one time I meet a friend of mine, he says, let her come and do interview. Then I said, if I didn't even know, let her come and do it again. You know, she did it. And she passed. Lakini interview Kenya Power. Said, Jamali, what if I didn't even? See how watu wako walikuwa Kenya Power pia hata wakati ule akifanya interview. But this time, she did it. And she got the job. How many times have you done interview and failed? Keep on doing it. How many times have you not? Keep on knocking. It doesn't matter. One of these days is going to open. Hallelujah, young man, if you're proposed and they're not talking to you, keep on talking. Amen. Dress up well. I mean, manukato kidogo, kiatu piga rangi. Muswaki kidogo, I mean, change your attire. But keep on knocking. You know, some of these men that you hear, you see here, greatly not. The first time we were in a, hey, sitakani mjeto ya vijanja. And today you are married to that person, how to have mjeto ya vijanja. So keep on knocking, brother, sister, you could be lucky next time. Don't let your past distract your future. Don't let your past distract your future too. Your failures are not fatal and they are not final. Even have failed ones, that's not final. It's just a failure. How many people here have ever failed? It wasn't final. Amen. Some of us did driving and we failed many times. Amen. But we still went back there until we passed. My first one, I never failed, but I knew. Did you appear to be kanyaga mawa ya kato? And it is not driving. Tuko kwa meza. Namambia nionyeshi. Anakwambia kijana. Nikisema umekanyaga mawa ya kato. Mimi, nimesema. Enda, kufanya practice zaidi. So I did it several times. When I passed, I carried the chief inspector in a matata. At that time, I was even carrying people in a matata. So I came with a matata and I gave him a ride. Actually, I balanced. So Mausha, have you ever driven? I said, yeah, I drive. I told him the whole truth. Asubuhi, before I bring the car to town, nipatie dereva, nitatokaka banana, nimejaza watu. Bas, where to rudi nikupatie barua. That day. But I had done it. Maua, situi payments, situi parking buyer, situi nini, hata siko nikitoka kwa meza. Maka namwambia, situanze kwa barabara, because I knew kwa barabara. I have no problem with barabara. Kwanze kwa barabara. Ni mwonyeshe vile natokaka na matatu, haraka na mawani, kutoka banana. Chief Inspector, nilimpeleka paka akaniambia, nitombe tuwa chelena Kariokoa, kujue kitu ile ya kule. Nikampeleka Kariokoa kachukua kile mtoto, tukarudi, napata barua. There are some of us here wameanguka. Do it again. How about mtihani wa Kiingereza? Hiyo safari imeanguka. Do it again. Book English only. Unajua naona mnacheka kwa sababu wengine ni hesabu. Do it again. Do it again. Keep on doing it. You will never know what God can do. Your failures are not fatal, they are not final. Don't let where you are also distract you from where God wants you to be. Because sometimes where we are today, we can't see where God wants to take us. We are distracted. Oh, I'm here, I can't move. No, don't allow that. David was held in the cave in Adullam. The enemy had him surrounded and were ready to kill him. But his mighty men of valor broke through the host of the Philistines. The end result was David coming out of the cave and defeating the Philistines. He was distracted for a while, but by the enemy, no matter how big their enemy was, but when they were breaking through, he realized that God was with him. God is still on your side. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He doesn't want destruction to become fatal. He wants to set us free. Hallelujah. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. Even as we bring this service to a close, maybe I was talking to you, there is that destruction which is obstructing you from seeing the Lord or pursuing your course. And you're saying today you would like the Lord to help you. Remove that destruction, remove that obstruction for you so that you can see the Lord. You know it is you. And if not is you, then lift up your hand to the Lord as we pray this final prayer. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we have decided to follow you. We don't want to turn back. Though none goes with us, though frustration and failures come many, we have decided to follow you. Lord, I speak into your people as their pastor, that Lord, any obstruction, any dear Father, things that have come to restrict them from being all that you want to be, their time is over. Their time is done. I pray that it will melt right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we also pray that it will melt before the presence of the Lord. May the anointing of God upon your people cause that obstruction, cause that restriction, dear Father, to fall from their shoulders, from their eyes. In the mighty name of Jesus, may they see the Lord. May they focus on you. May they get their redemption. May they get their deliverance. May they get their breakthrough. But Lord, I pray that there will be no obstruction that will obstruct them anymore. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you thanks and we give you praise for speaking to us today. In the mighty name of Jesus, we leave this service. We leave this day and we go to work and we go to do other things. We want to stay focused. We want to stay focused unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. Maybe you are there and you are feeling something within you. Maybe you are feeling unwell. And you are praying that today the Lord may touch you.
I want you to lift up your hand to the Lord. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, you are our healer. And this morning we did Holy Communion. Lord, Lord, may the virtues of Christ, may the virtues of Christ be the benefit that we get because of Holy Communion. May they come upon your people. And one of them is that by the stripes of Jesus, we were healed. We were healed. Receive your healing this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Maybe you are here, my brother, and you are saying, Bishop, I would like to give my life to Jesus. You have never given your life to the Lord, and it is good for us to finish this service with you. You are there, you want to give your life to the Lord. Just lift up your hand. Don't you worry about the people next to you. Just lift up your hand and pray for you quickly as you bring our service to the close. You know yourself. Nyosha mkono wako. Hebu tuone mkono. Nyosha kabisa. Wacha tuwe na wasiwasi. Nyosha kabisa.
Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you for our service. Blessed be your holy name. We also pray for the many other meetings that are coming after this. May your perfect will be done. May you be honored and glorified. In Jesus' name. And everybody say, Amen. Amen.